Hey everyone, welcome to my new kitchen. I am very excited because it's a brand new kitchen with an awesome stovetop and oven, and let's not forget my very own first dishwasher. Yes, I do make a lot of dishes, so this thing has been working quite a lot the last few days. And yeah, so here on the counter I went fruit shopping and there's a big bowl of fruit already here. And I bought this awesome cool toaster from a Bella brand, which I really, really like. It makes my toast just perfect. Got some more berries from my grocery shopping. What do I have? Oh, back here I have some lima beans that I'm soaking for a nice stew that I'm going to make probably tomorrow. Up here in this cabinet we have our glasses just for easy access. And right above that, I have just my baking pantry, which is pretty much packed right now. I don't think I could fit anything else in there. And then some containers up there above those. Yeah, there's a lot of stuff in here. I still gotta bake some more. Okay, in the fridge, what do we have here? We got some pickle ingredients here, some salsa, and also my vegan mayonnaise there in the back. We got some butter, vegan butter, peanut butter, applesauce, maple syrup, and my favorite So Fresh almond beverages. In the drawer down here, I have some grapes, and in this bag is something mysterious. What is it? It is oyster mushrooms. If you guys like flavors of the sea, these mushrooms are just like a taste of clams or mussels. They're awesome in a rice stew. And yes, these are lentils that I'm gonna make the lentil sliders with. Yes, with a bit of this rice. See, leftovers can make delicious food. You will soon see. Out there in the back is some vegan icing sugar that I have left. Some condiments here on the door. I have this vegan Caesar that I found. I make my own dressing, but once in a while I like to try new ones, which are very interesting, new flavors. And here I got some more pepper sauces and some hot sauces up here, lemon, my homemade tahini, my vitamins also here at the top, so remember to take them, hemp seeds. Yeah, that was pretty much the fridge. Onto the freezer. Don't have much going on here except for this cashew so delicious ice cream, which is my favorite. It's just like this Mars bar on steroids ice cream. It's yummy. I have some frozen fruit, but because this is berry season and lots of yummy fruits, I have them fresh. So that was some almond meal in the back for my almond milk. Yeah, moving on to my spice drawer. Oh, I have a lot of spices that I use, so I really wanted to dedicate a drawer just for my spices and cooking oils, and there they are, and with some salts and vinegars. But yeah, these are the main spices I use, paprika, oregano. Yep, this is just our cutlery, just simple. I had a big one that I found just to put all my cutlery in there. And okay, some plates here on this cabinet. Our coffee stuffed, hot chocolate, green tea latte, matcha lattes, cinnamons, dandies, vegan marshmallows, oatmeal. Up top, some snacks, some goji berries, some granola. And I must say, I love the lighting in this kitchen. Just makes everything so nice and bright to cook with. Yay! Moving on to the yummy, delicious lentil sliders. I have 3 cups of lentils that I've pre-cooked in this pot. I'm adding 1 teaspoon of just a very nice hot pepper paste. Half a teaspoon of garlic, a little bit of cayenne pepper, some paprika I'm adding here. Just quite a bit there. This is 3 cups of lentils, so there's some parsley, some dried parsley, and yep, my Himalayan salt, since I hadn't salted them, so good. Salt gives it some flavor. I'm also adding some black coarse salt, which I really like as well. And now I'm adding some rice, so that's about a cup of rice for like 3 cups of lentils. Gives it a good binding also, and a nice texture. So I'm just mashing that all together. It's funny how it kind of looks like kind of ground up meat. I'm adding also 1/2 cup of flour. Flour will be good to bind. So it's a bit dry now, and I'm gonna add 3 teaspoons of applesauce, which is gonna add like an egg binder. 1 tablespoon of mustard, another tablespoon of ketchup, so this is going to give some moistness and some flavor to the lentils, and just a splash of almond milk, so unsweetened almond milk, that was about 2 tablespoons. So you're going to see how the consistency of that is going to just turn out nice and burgery, if that's even a word. You can do this, you don't have to do this by hand, you can definitely do this with a masher, but I just feel like your hand and your fingers is just like, if you're not afraid to get them dirty, it just mixes things much better, and I think food just tastes better when you put the hand on it. So yeah, give it a good mash, and just try it out, see if it forms into a nice patty, like that. Nope, the camera is right there, yeah. Yeah, see? Pretty easy, huh? Now in a big pan, or you can bake these as well with some oil and a little bit healthier. I am adding some grapeseed oil, which I actually like, doesn't give it too much flavor to the burger since they already have their own flavor. Olive oil would give it a bit of a flavor. And once it's a bit hot, I'm putting a medium to high heat on a big oven, how do you call those circle thingies? Tops. Flip them over after about 3, yeah, I'm doing a little dance there, 3 to 4 minutes until they're nice and toasty on one side. Look at that. Look at that. Wow. Yeah. I'm going to tell you guys, this is delicious. I brought them to the beach, as you will soon see. And yeah, they're browning up. Mmm. And the last one, a little bit more. Okay, on to some yummy, since they're sliders and they're not big burgers, I'm putting them into some English muffins. This recipe makes about 10. I just made 3 here for the video and to just have fresh for the beach. Yeah, I'm saying yummy over there. I'm really proud of these burgers. They turned out looking delicious and they actually are really, really yummy. Yeah, and I'm going to top them with my favorite toppings, which is some veganese, some mustard, ketchup, and lettuce. Here we go. Look at those beautiful colors. You can see the lentils and the rice, ketchup, and some mayo. And yeah, that was simple. Those were like super easy to do and great with leftover lentils and a little bit of rice. And here I am at the beach with my English muffin bun and my freshly made lentil burger. I hope you guys get to make these at home. I made some more and I had them for lunch again today, and I'm going to freeze the rest for next time, and I can't wait till I eat them again. I hope you all enjoyed this video, and I'll have some more videos coming soon. Thank you.